So today I will tell you how you can update your WordPress website properly. It is very important to keep your website updated because every time we find some vulnerabilities and security loophole in the various plugins and themes we use on the WordPress website. So it is highly recommended if you want to keep your website safe and secure, you need to update your plugin themes and WordPress version time to time. If you watch this video until the end, you will be able to keep your website secure and very hard for hackers to hack. And sometimes what happens when you update your WordPress website, then your website break because of the updated plugins or the theme. They're not compatible with each other or with your WordPress version, or there is some issue with the updates. So in this video, I'm not just going to tell you how to update your website. I'm going to tell you how to deal with these kind of issues. So whenever you update your website, it goes a smooth process and you will be able to update your website without any issues. Before we move forward, I would like to tell you, in this channel, I give a lot of important tips and tricks that how you can create your website, how you can manage your website, and how you can keep it more secure and safe. So I highly recommend you, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, do it right now, because it will give you a lot of useful information so that you will always stay updated in your website game. Also, I want to give you a little disclaimer. If you run a sensitive website or you run an e-commerce website with high volume, I recommend you to take help of an experienced developer. And if you're confident that you can update your website by yourself, just follow the tutorial. In the end of the video, you'll be able to update your website yourself. You do not need to pay to any developer also. Let's go into my computer screen and see that how you can update your website and deal all the issues which comes while updating the WordPress website. I'll try to make this video compact and to the point. So please like the video. It just takes 2 seconds and it takes a lot of time for me to make these kind of videos. And then it makes your life simple while it comes to managing your website. So like the video and subscribe to my channel. Okay, so I divided this video in 4 parts. First part will be taking backup of website. So if something goes bad, we can recover your website from these backups. Second part will be updating WordPress version. Third part will be updating plugins, and fourth part will be updating the themes. So we'll do everything step by step, and I will tell you how you can deal with the issues. If your website breaks with these updates, how you can deal with that also. So first of all, you need to log in into your WordPress dashboard. And you can see here from left sidebar in the dashboard menu, the second option is updates. So click on updates. This is a section which tells us that what are the updates required for a website. Right now you can see I'm using the latest version of WordPress. But if you're not using the latest version, you will have a notice here that you need to update your WordPress version. If you're using version less than 5.5.3 as of now, you will have an update now option here. And then we have all the plugins which we need to update. And then we have option to update the theme. I'm using Astra theme. So the easy way is we can just update the WordPress form here by update now and select all the plugins and click on update plugins. It will update all the plugins in one go. And then the same thing we can do with themes. We can just select all themes and then update those themes in one click. But as I told you, we will do this the right way. So this is not the right procedure because it is so quick. If something bad happens, it will be very hard to identify that what bad happened with your website and which update broke your website. So instead of clicking all, instead of selecting all, updating them in once, we'll update one by one. Before we do anything, I will create a backup website, which is the first step everybody should do to take a backup website before updating anything on your website. In order to take a backup, I'm using Updraft plus backup plugin. So I'll go to left sidebar on settings and then click on Updraft plus backup. If you want to see my video that how you can take backup of your website in the most easy way, I'll put an I link on the top right and you can watch the detailed tutorial how you can take backup of your website. In this video, I'm just going to take help of this plugin Updraft plus backup. So check out those videos and take a backup first of your website. So I click on backup now. It will ask you want to include database and all the files in your backup. So I'll take a full backup. I click on backup now. It may take some time. Okay, so backup is finished running. I close this pop-up. As you can see, this is the latest backup of my website. Now I can make sure that if something goes bad while updating, I can always recover my website. Okay, so as we told, we'll do step by step. So first thing, we'll update the WordPress version. So to update WordPress version, go here dashboard and then click on updates. Because I'm using the latest version, so I do not have this option. But if you're using less than 5.5.3 as of now, you will have update now. So just click on update now and your WordPress version will be updated. Then second thing we need to do is updating plugins. So I'll hover on plugins and then click on install. And now instead of selecting all and updating them in once, I'll update one by one. For example, I'll update this first plugin, click on update now. And what we are going to achieve is updating them with peace of mind. So once I update one plugin, I'll go back to my website, I'll refresh my website, I'll see if something break on my website. If something broke on my website, I will understand that this plugin update is making a problem. So I'll make sure that I do not update this plugin. I'll write to the author of this plugin that, okay, your new version is breaking my website. or I can wait for the next version of this plugin until they fix this issue. So same thing I'll do with the all plugins. This plugin is not activated, but I recommend you to keep everything updated on your website. So after updating every plugin, I'll go back to my website. I'll check very quickly if something break or not on my website. If everything looks fine, I'll keep updating the plugins. So I'll update all the plugins like this way. Okay, in case something goes bad, I updated this plugin and something goes bad. What I am going to do in this case, I'll go back to settings and then Updraft Plus Backups. So as you see, I updated plugin. So what I will do, I'll do a restore. So I'll click on restore. And as we updated a plugin which broke my website, so I click on plugins and then I click next. And then I'll click restore. So what went bad on my website will be recovered in this case. Then again, once it is done restoring all the plugins, I can go back on my website. As you can see here, I already updated these three plugins which broke my website, or one of them broke my website. I refreshed this page. And you can see all these plugins are not updated because I restored all the plugins from my backup. Okay, so you have to do this. You have to understand that which plugin break your website and do not update that plugin. Either write to the author of the plugin or just wait for the next version to come. So this is the part of updating plugins, and we see what we will do if some plugin break our website. And now we'll go to themes and update our theme. To update themes, you go to appearance and then click on themes. You can see here I have four themes installed on my website, but this one is active theme. So what you can do, you can remove all the themes which you do not use on website. I recommend you to keep just one active theme and one default theme for WordPress. This is my test website, so I'll keep these themes, but I recommend you to keep active theme and just one WordPress theme which come default with WordPress version. Maybe it can be 2019, 2020 or 2018 or 2017. So I'll click on update now. Okay, theme is updated. Now I will do a really fast check. I'll go back on my website, I'll refresh the page, and I'll make sure that nothing broke on my website after updating the theme. If something broke, we'll do the same thing what we did when the plugin broke our website. We'll go back to the settings and click on Updraft Plus Backups. If you want to watch my video, I'll put an I link on the top right so you can understand how you can take backup of a website. I made two videos about how you can take backup of a website using Updraft Plus Backup plugin, or you can watch the video where you can take backup via cPanel. So for example, that theme update broke my website. So I'll go back here, I click on restore, and I select themes and then next, and I will do a restore how I did with the plugin. Okay, so theme restore is successful. I'll go back to my website and now I'll go to appearance and themes. So you can see here it is showing update now option again because I restored the theme to its previous version. So if this theme broke your website, just write to the author of the theme or wait for the next version of theme to come where they fix this issue. Okay, this is how you update your WordPress website the right way, and I show you if something bad happens, how you can restore your website and how you can handle with that issue. I hope you like the video. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. As I told you, it just takes 2 seconds. So do that right now and subscribe to my channel to receive all these important updates to manage your website, add useful functionality on your website, and to make your website faster and more secure.